Leia and Carlos have been friends and have lived right next door to each other since they were born. When Carlos's mother had to move to Cerdanyola do Vallès to work at the Institute of Microelectronics of Barcelona, they are both afraid that they will never see each other again. But that will never happen, since now they have mobile phones, online games, computers, and loads of things that easily keep them connected. They are unaware that integrated circuits play a key role in making all this possible, but the question is, how exactly do these circuits achieve it? The origins trace back to 1947, when three researchers at Bell Labs in the United States developed the first transistor. This first point-contact transistor, constructed from germanium, was large, expensive to produce, and came with numerous technical constraints. Nevertheless, it laid the groundwork for the silicon bipolar transistor, which was invented the following year, boasting significantly improved performance and features. One of the inventors moved to California and founded the Shockley Semiconductor Laboratory, marking the inception of the first company in the area that would become known as Silicon Valley. The transistor has three terminals and operates like an electron tap. Initially, it obstructs the flow of electric current until a small voltage is applied at its base. This voltage allows the current to pass through, activating the circuit. This behavior makes them perfect for the physical implementation of the ones and zeros of digital applications. Moreover, their ability to amplify exceedingly weak electrical signals is useful. Here, the weak signal activates the transistor, which subsequently produces a large signal response. However, this story started earlier, with the invention of the telephone and the need to make long-distance calls, which were possible thanks to the vacuum tubes. An instrument that posed challenges due to their substantial size and inefficiency. They were also prone to frequent failures and burnouts. The first transistors resolved this problem, and they were the base for the first handheld radios. The evolution of silicon-based microelectronics technology was advanced by inventors Robert Noyce and Jack Kilby. They achieved the integration of numerous transistors onto a single semiconductor substrate, enabling the creation of intricate electronic circuits within a confined space. This groundbreaking achievement marked the birth of the integrated circuit, commonly known as the chip. Subsequently, researchers Dewan Khan and Mohammed Atala pioneered the creation of a new breed of transistors known as MOSFET, which are much more efficient and with greater potential. These advancements proved particularly impactful for the development of digital circuits, specifically for microprocessors and memories. The digital revolution had begun. These small devices are all around us today, in diagnostic equipment, hearing aids, mobiles, gaming consoles, dishwashers, kitchen robots, cars. Since 1947, transistors have undergone continual evolution. With advancements over the years, their production has soared into the millions and their size has progressively diminished. This reduction in size allows for the integration of numerous transistors into compact integrated circuits, giving them enhanced functionality. Today, we can integrate thousands of millions of transistors measuring only a few dozen nanometers onto a single chip. Are we reaching the limits of reducing their size? Now, Leia and Carlos know that they can keep in touch in so many different ways. And Carlos's mother can keep doing research in micro and nano electronics at the Institute of Microelectronics of Barcelona. Who knows, if you could be the one to make the next discovery?